everyone, this is Dr. Kazi, and in this video, we are going to learn about the clinicals of the bone present in your forearm, the radius and the ulna bone. We're going to discuss about the Monteggia's fracture, the Galeazzi's fracture, the Colle's, and finally the Smith's fracture. Let's discuss that one by one. The forearm consists of two bones, the radius and the ulna bone. The radius is present on the lateral side and the ulna is present on the medial side. Now, the bone is divided into three parts: the proximal part, the body or the shaft, and the distal extremity. Have a look at this diagram. The humerus bone is making the elbow joint with the radius and the ulna bone. Now, the head of the radius bone is fractured. When a person falls on the outstretched hand, the head is driven sharply against this capitulum, which is present on the humerus bone. Also, when a person falls on the outstretched hand, the neck of the radius is also broken down. Now, let's talk about the Monteggia's and the Galeazzi's fracture. It follows a condition, that is, when one bone is broken down, the other bone is dislocated. In other words, the fracture of one bone is associated or linked with the dislocation of the other bone. Have a look. There is a fracture of the ulna shaft or the ulna body. The head of the radius bone is dislocated from the elbow joint. This is Monteggia's fracture. Now, Galeazzi's fracture is also very similar, but the bones are different. That is, the fracture is at the proximal third of the radius bone and the head of the ulna is dislocated, which is present at the wrist joint. Now, let's talk about the Colle's and the Smith's fracture. It happens when a person falls on the outstretched hand, something like this. There's the fracture of the distal end of the radius bone. Both Colle's and Smith's fracture is the fracture of the distal end. But what is the difference between the two? Have a look at this diagram. There is the posterior bump in the Colle's fracture. The Colle's fracture is also known as the dinner fork deformity. It is very similar to the kitchen utensil fork. That is why it is known as the dinner fork deformity. Now, the fracture is at the distal end and it has two fragments, the distal fragment and the proximal fragment. The distal fragment is directed dorsally in case of Colle's fracture. Have a look at the Smith's fracture. The distal fragment is displaced ventrally in case of Smith's fracture. That is the difference between the Colle's and the Smith's fracture. The arrangement of the fragment. One distal fragment is displaced dorsally, and in case of Smith fracture, the distal fragment is displaced ventrally. And this fracture happens when a person falls on the back of the hand. This was all about the clinicals of the bones, and I will see you in the next video.